Okay, so I just want to. So we are all working on the waiting. I just want to step through the waiting here just to show you guys. If you don't mind clicking on Mr. Scorpion here, how many of you guys downloaded my file? Okay, cool. If you had your own, that's cool too. So click on the Scorpion and then double click the Paint Skin Weights tool. And what I want to do is start at the top and click on the root joint in the Paint Skin Weights tool. And what I want to do is go through each one of the joints here. So basically, click root and then you tap down arrow on your keyboard. You're going to cycle through each one of the weights. And if you're looking at my file, you can kind of see. So spine was kind of like the center there. Then you can keep clicking down arrow after you click a joint, and it will cycle through all of the weights, and you can see that if you were having problems, it is entirely possible to do this. And just to show you that I'm not like blowing a bunch of smoke up your ass. It was a challenge, but yeah, this guy was rough. And I think it's a combination. Why this guy was so rough is because it's a combination of that just he has a lot of like crazy shapes, and his legs and spine and all that sort of stuff is just real in close proximity to everything. So when Maya does its auto-weighting stuff, it kind of like has problems determining what exactly you want. Maya's not a mind reader. And then also this skin normalize weights, enabling weight normalization seem to help a lot with the problem that I discussed earlier with regards to you going through and painting stuff and then going back and the stuff that you had done was now like jacked up. But it required me to like, I mean, I had to like, I'd like do a leg, and then I'd mirror it, and then I'd start on another leg, and then when I'd go back and look at the leg I did before, it was like, it had new white stuff all over the place, and the, just little thing. So then I'd have to paint that out again, and it took like a couple times for certain limbs or certain things of just going back and painting stuff out, but eventually it got to the point to where it was fine. So it's just sometimes it's just a process. It's not as easy as just going through once and having it good to go. All right, so now we can go ahead and put some controls in this guy and do some of the fun stuff. Let's go ahead and start off with our main root control. So click on the curves tab in the upper left, and we're gonna just make a circle. A circle curve like this, and it's just going to encompass his entire leg span, just like this. And if you click on the curves tab in the upper left, click the little circle hula hoop once, it'll create it in the center of the grid, and then you can create and scale a loop, just like this. And as you create these controls, it is good practice to name them. So you can name this control root control. And you don't have to name out, you don't have to write out control. You can just write CTRL if you want. That's what I do. So just click it once.
Don't import it. Just open it. Should just be a. Did you do import?
Yeah.
Yeah. Just do a open.
Right. So the next thing we're gonna want to do is we'll work on the tail. So that's the easiest. You want to duplicate that curve, Control D, and I would start at the top of the tail. And it may be a good idea to hide the polygons just because they might get in the way. But basically what you're going to do is duplicate that curve and V-snap it to each one of the tail joints. And as you move with your... if you move the curve around, if you hold V, it will snap to joints. Okay? And again, if you turning off the polygons are really going to help with snapping. So if you just go to show and then turn off polygons like this, it's going to be a lot more, since we're just dealing with the joints. So you're just going to duplicate again and snap to the other tail, duplicate again, snap to the other tail. And to be honest with you, you could do this for all of the spine joints and the head. So you can just start with the tail and go all the way down the spine until you get to the head. We're gonna need loops for every single one of them. So you're just duplicating them and snapping them to each joint. And yeah, you can go ahead and do the clippers too. So if you look up at the projector, you can see kind of what I've done. I've gone all the way down the tail and given little hoops for the clippers as well. So all I'm doing is duplicating and snapping right now.
How'd you go into that wireframe mode? Or the joint mode?
You just go to show and turn off polygons. No problem. Anybody going to any Halloween parties this weekend? Next weekend? Are you guys dressing up for Halloween? Who's planning on coming to school dressed up? Yes? Nice. Thank you. Okay, then what we're gonna do is you can turn back on your polygon mesh. And what you're gonna do is after you've snapped these guys, you're just gonna rotate them to an angle that you feel like kind of makes sense and scale them to a scale that kind of works for you, that you feel like kind of molds their way around the scorpion. Like, see how I've kind of done this here? You kind of want to fit them around. Don't want them to be too big. And another thing you're gonna need is for each of the feet, we're gonna need like a little circle like this. So give them little circles at the bottom of each one of his feet. And there's a a bone there that should be very easy to snap those two. Thank you. And if you guys look up here, I've also created six, they're called locators, and I've snapped them to the knees. We need those also for knee control. These are like these little sprocket looking things in the rigging tab all the way to the left. So create me six little locators and snap them to the knees. Anybody need any help? What happened? Say again? Snap to point? Is it, you're so if you look up at the projector, I've got circles for everything, scaled and rotated to fit around my scorpion, especially for the feet as well. And then I've created six little locators and snap them to the knees. The locator tools where my mouse pointer is. We need those for knee control. And if you it's as you're moving these controls around, if you hold V on your keyboard as you move, it'll snap to the joints. And in order to hide, it's much more helpful to hide the geometry. You just go to show and turn off polygons, and that's going to help you All right, are we waiting on anybody? Anybody need any help? Sure, we're not waiting on anybody?
Yeah, I'm still doing stuff, but you can move ahead.
Okay. So we're all happy with our placement and our scale of our controls here. We're all set up. Everything's all good. One of the things we're going to need to do before we start attaching controls to the bones is we're going to need to delete the history on all of these controls. So what I want you to do is click on Show, and then click, you can pop the window out by clicking the little bar at the top, and I want you to show, click None and hide everything, okay? Click None and hide everything. Then I want you to just to turn on NURBS, Curves, and Locators. NURBS, Curves, and Locators. Okay. Now what I want you to do is just drag a box and select everything. We're going to select all of our controls at the same time, and then go up to Edit, Delete, By Type, History. Edit, Delete, By Type, History. And that's going to do is clear off all the history on everything, so it makes Maya think these controls were just created from scratch in this place, in the place that they're at now. Okay. Now what we're going to do is we're going to delete transformations, but we're going to keep the scale. We don't want to affect the scale, because if we, edit, delete, by type, history. Yeah, make sure you have everything selected. Edit, delete, by type, history. Not delete all by type, because that'll kill all everything we've done. Okay. So now we're going to go to Modify, same thing selected. Go to Modify and the option box for Freeze Transformations. The option box for Freeze Transformations. Okay. So we got a bunch of options here. And what Freezing Transformations does, if you look over in the channel box, you'll see that in Translate XYZ, there's values. Okay. We want these values to be set to 0. So that at any given time, if you want to set your scorpion back to his current pose, you just select all the controls and change all those values to 0. But what we don't want to do is affect the scale, because we're really happy with it's going to snap back the scale to the original size of kind of everything here. And actually, before we do this, shift select all these locators here. Just shift select all 6 locators, and what I want you to do is just move them up just a little bit above the scorpion, and then change the scale to 0.5 in the channel box. So just kind of move them up a little bit so they're going to be above the knees, and then change the scale to 0.5 in the channel box. Okay. All right. So then now reselect everything, and then you're going to uncheck scale and then hit apply. Uncheck scale and then hit apply. Okay. And you'll see we still have some scale values over here to the right. And so what we're going to do is with everything selected, I want you to shift select the scale values like this. Shift select the scale values like this of everything. Then right click anywhere in the blue. And then go down to lock and hide selected. Lock and hide selected. And that's a cool little tool to hide channels of certain controls to make it to where an animator can't find those. Because you really are, your whole goal is to like lock this down to where an animator can just animate with it and not do anything else with it. Because if you give too much power to the animators, you're going to break your rig. And you don't want them breaking your rig, okay? All right, so you can close out of that freeze transformation window. And then just go ahead and turn joints back on in your show tab here, okay? All right, cool. So now we're going to go through the process of constraining the controls to the joints, okay? We are going to constrain every single control you see with the exception of the feet controls and the locators. So all the tail, all down the way to the claws, and then the big circle. Let's start with the big circle first, okay? So what I want you to do is select the big circle control, shift select the root joint, and then you're gonna go to constrain. And what I want you to do is pop out your constrain window. Okay, if you don't see constrain up at the top, change your drop down in the upper left to rigging. So then go to constrain and pop out your constrain window. And then I want you to go to the option box for parent constrain. Okay, go to the option box for parent constrain. And everything should be set the way we want it. What this is going to do is it's going to constrain that root joint to this big control. And we have maintain offset turned on. And then we have translate and rotate. So it's going to control the translate and rotate. So go ahead and just click apply. Okay. And when you do that, if you move that big circle around now, you can see that it moves the entire skeleton. That's what we want. We want, when you grab the big control, it's going to move that entire skeleton. Okay, that's going to be our global move control. So now I want you to parent constrain all the controls from the tail all the way down to the claws. Okay, so you're going to start by clicking the tip of the tail bone, the control first, then shift select the tip of the tail and hit apply. And if the movement arrows are in your way, just tap the T on your keyboard and they will disappear. And you can, they'll get out of the way. All right, so you select control first. Shift select the bone you want it to control, then click apply. Control first, bone, apply. Control first, bone, apply. And work your way all the way down the tail. By just clicking the control you want to control, shift select the bone, and then hit apply. No, we're not parenting, we're constraining. There's a difference. Okay. The difference is parenting actually puts it in the hierarchy. Constraining keeps it out of the hierarchy. Okay. But they have basically the same function. And when you're done with all those, you want to go through and you can turn your polygons back on and test each and make sure it's doing what it's supposed to be doing. Now, for all you pros who are done already, what you're going to do is you're going to parent each one to each control to each other, headed down the tail until you get to the center, and then you're going to parent the opposite direction from the claws down through the head, if that makes sense. So for example, I'm going to select my tip of my tail control, select the next control down, and tap P. Oh god, why did that do that? That is so odd. Why on earth did that do that? I don't know why, but Maya's making my life really difficult today. You should be able to parent those controls headed down the joint chain without any problems. What's that?
It does the same thing.
I have no idea why it does that. It shouldn't. Yeah, not the feet and not the knees. Yeah.
Unless I just went like below.
We did it a little different, but. I just don't understand why that's doing it. I've never seen this do that before. So weird. Translate, rotate. What the heck? So weird. Shift. Yeah.
For some reason it's like showing that he's working when I'm trying to
say again. You have two scorpions. Is this my file? Do me a favor. Alright, so undo that. Okay, so click on the scorpion. Actually, go to. Here, let me just.
Thank you.
All right, is everybody caught up? Okay, I'm literally about to pick this computer up and throw it out the window. So, I'm having this weird issue, and I know there's a setting somewhere, and I don't know where it's at, but basically, when I have objects like this, or controls, or anything, and I parent them to each other, so if I select one, select the other one, and hit P, it's supposed to just parent the object to the other object, but it's supposed to maintain where it's at. For some strange reason, it changes position. And that's what's happening here with the tail. When I select these two, they're just supposed to parent to each other, but they change position. And I don't know why that is. It might be in the settings somewhere. I've never seen this before, but of course, whenever you're trying to, you always experience new issues.
Whenever I had my hand, one of the controls would jump to another location. I know that there's a setting for that. I think that might be it.
Parent options or other
settings. Where at? Edit parent option box. Yeah, I looked at those, and preserve position is on, but it still does it. I mean, I literally just created two brand new boxes and selected one, select the other one, and tap P, and it jumps its offset. I've never seen that before. I don't know why. Never in my life has it done that. Except for today. Just wonderful. I don't even, it's even like kind of hard to search for that in Google, because it's not supposed to do that. All right, so let's do this. Let's pause on that problem and move on to a different problem. Let's focus on doing the legs. So let's build out some IKs for the legs. What we're going to do is we're going to create an IK chain for the legs. So click on your rigging tab, and next to the joint tool is the create IK handle tool. Go ahead and double click that. And it defaults to rotate plane solver, which is good. So you can just close out of that. All right, so what you're gonna do, everybody look up here for a second. So what you're gonna do is you're gonna pick a leg. I'm just gonna start with this front one here. and I'm going to click the top of the front leg and then click the bottom of the front leg. And you want to make sure everything's turned on except for polygons. And what that's going to do is going to create like a little rubber band IK handle here for the leg. Okay, so you just click your IK handle tool and you're going to click the start of the leg joint and then click the end of the leg joint, and it's going to create a control that's kind of like a rubber band for your legs, okay? And you're going to do that for all legs. And if you mess it up, just go ahead and you can select the handle and you can just delete it. Alright, everybody got that? Got all the IKs created? Alright, so what we're going to do now is, since parenting doesn't work, we are going to do a parent constrain the IK to the foot control. So what you're going to do is you're going to select the foot control, shift select the IK, and then go to constrain parent. Constrain parent, so that when you move the foot control, it moves the IK. Okay, I'll go over that again. So you're going to select the foot control first, hold shift and drag a box over the foot, and it'll shift select the IK. Then you just go to constrain parent. Okay, I'll do it again. I'll select the foot control, hold shift, drag a box over the foot here, and it will select the IK. Then you go to constrain parent, so that when you move the foot control, it's going to move the IK. Everybody got that? Anybody need me to go over it again? I'll do it one more time. So I'm going to select the foot control first, hold shift and drag a box, and it'll select the IK. Then I can go to constrain parent. Then when I select the foot control and move it, It's gonna move the IK. You wanna do that for all feet. All right, everybody got that? So when you move the feet control here, it should move the entire foot. Okay? Everybody got that? That's a real quick and easy way to make a leg work. Okay, so the next step here is we're gonna hook the knee controls to the IKs, okay? It's very simple to do that. These knee controls are these little sprocket-looking things up here, these locators. So what you're going to do is you are going to, I believe, select the knee control first, then shift select the IK, and go to constrain pole vector. Constrain pole vector. So then when you move that knee control, the knee will point at it. Okay, that's going to be very helpful for having knee point stuff. Okay, I'll do that again. So you are going to select the knee control first, then shift select the IK handle for the leg that matches it, then go to constrain pole vector. Okay, knee control first, shift select the IK handle to the matching leg, constrain pole vector. Then when you move the knee controls, you'll see that they move the knee of Mr. Scorpion. That's going to be very handy for posing this guy. So I'll do it again. Select the knee control. Shift select the IK handle for the matching leg. Constrain pole vector. Do it for all the legs. go ahead and save your scenes. Yep. Say that again. Uh-huh. Yes. And then the tip. The top part of the leg, the toppest part of the leg. It looks like it's doing what it's supposed to be doing. It just looks like the weighting is off. Click the Scorpion model. Yeah, just select the model. You've got your... look up where my mouse is. Yeah, see how that's expanded? Are all those things selected, or are some of them missing? So when you can't select your object? How many copies of Maya do you have open there? Okay. Anybody having any weird problems? All right. So I figured out how we can bypass the parenting issue of weird parenting. Like where you parent something and it jumps. And I'm just going to show you guys how to do it here. So just kind of sit back, relax, and just look up here. So the problem was that, so I have all these controls here. They're all parented to the joints, right? But the problem is we want to parent the controls to each other so that when I rotate one, it rotates the one above that and so forth and so on. The problem is when I parent them, they jump like that. And I don't know why it's doing that. I've never seen that before in my entire life. So what we're going to do is we're going to go around it. We're going to just do it another way. And what we're going to use is a parent constraint. The problem is we can't parent constraint these two directly together. So what we're going to do is I'm going to group this control. Okay. And when I group that control, it's going to create a group for it, okay? And then I'm going to parent constrain the group to the control. So I'm just going to control, so I'm going to select the control first, then select the group constrain parent. So now when I rotate the control, it rotates the one above it. Okay, that's the desired result that we want. It's just going to have to jump through a few hoops to get there. So what you do is you select a control. And it's good to have your hypergraph hierarchy open here while you're doing this. So if you go to Windows, General Editors, Hypergraph Hierarchy. So you're going to select a control. And then find it in your hypergraph hierarchy by just clicking F for find. And then you're going to group it, Control G. You'll have to find it again by clicking F. So you're looking at the group. So then you're going to select the control below it, then shift select the group, and parent constrain that. So when you rotate the control, it's going to rotate the one above it, and so on and so forth. Okay, I'll do that again. So you're gonna have to work your way down the tail. So again, with my hypergraph hierarchy open here, I'm gonna select one control and group it. Then click F in your hypergraph hierarchy to find it. You'll see the group and the control. Select the control below it. Shift select the group, constrain, parent. So then as you rotate that control, it rotates the one above it, and so on and so forth. I'll do it again. Grab a control that's not grouped, find it in the hierarchy, control G, then click F again to find it. Select the control below it, shift select the group, constrain, parent. So now that control rotates the one above it, and so on and so forth. I'll do that again here. All we're trying to do is get each control to control the one below it when I rotate it, okay? So the way you do that is here. Open your hypergraph hierarchy, Windows, General Editors, Hypergraph Hierarchy. Select a control. And click F, find it. Then you're going to group it, Control G. Then click F to find it again. You'll see the group and the control. You're going to select the control below it, shift select the group, constrain, parent. Okay? And you're going to work your way all the way down the creature until you get to the center. The center will control everything but the tail up, and then you're gonna have to work from the claws down to the head to that center control. I'll do it again here. I'm gonna find a control I need to control. I'll group it, control G, then click F in the hypergraph hierarchy to find it. Select the control below it. Shift select the group, constrain, parent. So now as I rotate each one of these controls, it will rotate the tail above it. Just kind of annoying that we have to do this, because we should be able to just parent them, but for whatever reason today is one of those days and stuff just isn't working right.
Thank you.
this ankle strain.
This.
Makes sense?
Okay.
So you group every single one individually and then constrain it to the control below it.
Okay.
Anybody need any help? I know this is kind of like a backdoor approach to getting it done, but it'll still get it done.
Sometimes you have to come up with creative solutions to get stuff to work.
I All right, guys, let's wrap here for today. I've beaten you guys up enough over the scorpion. We can wrap this guy next time.
Punch the scorpion.